You're probably like billions of other people on planet Earth, happily going about your daily life without a care in the world for any of the fundamental forces that make life on Earth possible. Yet, even as you watch this video, one of those forces is experiencing an unexplained anomaly and unexpectedly weakening, potentially leaving the Earth vulnerable to the almost complete extinction of life. If what scientists are watching develop in real time persists, humanity has at best years left to live, and the only thing to survive us will be microbial life in the deepest caves or darkest depths. In 1958, it was well understood that the sun sent a steady stream of very dangerous high-energy particles and radiation crashing toward Earth. What kept life safe from this peril was the Earth's powerful magnetic field, stretching out thousands of miles into space and shielding us from the worst of the solar wind. So try to imagine their horror when scientists in 1958 discovered that this invisible shield we rely on for life to continue on Earth was actually weakening. Known as the South Atlantic Anomaly, it's an area of weakening magnetic field that grows on average by 12.4 miles per year. The area has been closely monitored since its discovery, and today, this chink in the Earth's protective armor comes down to just over 100 miles over the surface of our planet. The anomaly has already taken a devastating toll on manned and unmanned spacecraft, and modern satellites can't operate in the area without special precautions or risk destruction. But what is this anomaly exactly, and why is it so dangerous? Well, Texans might not like it, but the truth is all life on Earth is solar-powered. Yes, even you. The food you eat either ate food that got its energy from the sun or was food that got its energy from the sun. For the kids in the cheap seats, we're talking about plants here. The sun is basically the giver of all life, but it can also be the taker of that same life. That's because all that nice warm sunshine you enjoy on a sunny summer day is only a tiny percentage of the energy the sun is blasting out into space in your direction. Basically, the sun is blasting a pure murder hate beam of radiation straight at your dumb face. But good guy Earth is there to shield you from the worst of it all, so all you feel is a nice warm ray of light and maybe some slight sunburn. And that's thanks to the Earth's magnetic field, which is generated by the movement of molten iron and nickel in the Earth's core. All that moving and shaking of those metals in our molten core generates a massive electrical current, which in turn creates a magnetic field which stretches out deep into space. That magnetic field is in effect a shield, which deflects or traps harmful solar wind and ensures that instead of your DNA being blasted apart, you'll at worst suffer a sunburn from staying outside too long. But just how bad could it really be if the magnetic field were to collapse suddenly? That's a great question, and we're glad you asked. 4.5 billion years ago, Mars had a thick, luscious atmosphere and plenty of liquid water to go around. We can see evidence of huge lakes and rivers all over the surface of the planet, and we know from studying the chemistry of the planet that it once was wrapped up in a thick atmosphere. Then everything changed, in geological timescales practically overnight. The world that might have once held an advanced dolphin species capable of spaceflight – you can't prove that it didn't exist – is today only a dusty rock. The killer? Its magnetic field. Scientists still don't understand why Mars's magnetic field shut down, but they believe it was due to its smaller size compared to Earth, as well as the composition of its core. The Earth is bigger than Mars, almost twice as big, which means that we have a large molten core that would take longer to cool than Mars's own core. But that might only be part of the picture. Rock is a great insulator. That's why our core has remained molten so long. But it's not just heat from its original formation that's still keeping the core hot, but also the decay of radioactive elements inside our core that's helping to keep things nice and warm. Some scientists suspect that Mars lacked such heavy radioactive elements in its own core, which would have led to a much faster cooling core than the Earth's own. With a weakening magnetic field, the solar wind sandblasted Mars's atmosphere away, and eventually its water. Any life, such as spacefaring dolphins, would have been bombarded by cosmic and solar radiation, their DNA destroyed by the high-energy particles ripping it to pieces. Unless that life moved deep underground, extinction was quick to follow. And now it may happen here on Earth. The South Atlantic Anomaly has been closely monitored for decades and has now split into two valleys that continue to move across the ocean and grow in size. However, it's not quite all doom and gloom just yet, as new data shows that the anomaly may perhaps be part of a natural cycle that's going on for millions of years. We already know to expect anomalies in the Earth's magnetic field, and that's because the molten core is not uniform in its iron and nickel content, whose motion generates the magnetic field. These irregularities in the content will inevitably lead to irregularities in the strength of the magnetic field around the Earth. and thus the Southern Atlantic Anomaly is born. There's no evidence that the Earth's magnetic field ever weakened to the point of causing a mass extinction event, so scientists are hopeful that the SAA will continue to evolve over time before eventually correcting itself. For now, the greatest danger that the SAA possesses is to low Earth satellites, which frequently pass through the anomaly. They must be careful to shut down sensitive electronics or suffer serious consequences, such as the Japanese satellite that destroyed itself when charged particles slipping through the weakened magnetic field damaged some of its electronics. Even the space shuttle experienced the shutting down of laptops as it flew through the anomaly, and the ISS regularly passes through it, but thanks to its thick shielding, suffers few if any ill effects. While scientists don't suspect the SAA to lead to a magnetic field collapse, there may be no telling how the Southern Atlantic Anomaly evolves in the future. If things take a turn for the worse and the anomaly dips below the atmosphere, something it's already dangerously close to doing, it could spell disaster for any living beings in the geographic vicinity of the anomaly. Thankfully, for now, the anomaly is over the Southern Atlantic. But as it moves and grows, it could eventually pass over heavy population centers. What the Southern Atlantic Anomaly means for life on Earth is still largely unknown. Before we're all disintegrated by an angry sun, go watch Worst Natural Disasters in Human History, or click this other video instead.